Okay. So, to brief on the AVP group of institutions, you would be all be aware of Krishna Kumarji, who is actually a standing mentor always, even though he passed away. It is like his memories will always be fresh. He was a person who was actually living a life on Ayurveda, for Ayurveda, and to propagate Ayurveda, because he understood that it is actually not to keep with himself, it is actually to spread the word so that there can be so much of good things happening to people. Just like in Ayurveda also, you can see Charaka, Shushruta, Vagbhata and all. These people were like nomads who used to travel to spread the word of Ayurveda so as to help in creating a living atmosphere in a healthy pattern. Rather than actually those people have explained beautifully about diseases. But the first concern was always to create a very good ambience or create a circumstance and all to establish how you can be healthy. So always I also advocate the same thing. Like whenever my patient comes, I always say, take your medication for some period of time in a very strict manner so that after some period you're free out of it. You come out of the disease also, but during that period you need to follow some things that to be followed. In that, actually one of the topic is patya, which the term patya is very important because it is actually understood as patya. Patya means something which is actually very much compatible to the body. That means it will not create any kind of problems to the body. So patya can be one in for example, when you consider a person, their constitutional differences will be there. At the same time, a person with approximately same constitution of two people, if you get also, when it comes to a disease pattern, it will be completely different. So how the pattern shows in a patient A and a patient B will be entirely different. So patya is also very much customized. So generally we can say, okay, you should not use non-vegetarian food during this period so that you don't have to create any digestive differences. But at the same time, for some people we advocate you should take mutton because this will actually help you in increasing your muscle improvement. You will actually help in increasing your bone strength. For that you actually you advocate the use of the bone of the goat. So all these are there. So the patya is actually like customized for a person. So I wanted to tell you this patya because it's very important when it comes to ahara. So going to the topic, the ahara is a point which actually has Ayurvedic terminologies meaning bhakshanam. Bhakshanam is to intake.
Aramya,
yeah, please.
Sorry to interrupt you. There are few people not able to see the PPT. Can you really? Just see?
Actually, it's mentioned here is meet.google.com is sharing a window. Should I stop sharing and try once again?
No. Aparna, now I can see. Maybe you want to put it in the presentation mode.
Okay. Presentation mode. Can you just please, Aramya, put it in a presentation mode or something?
It's actually presentation mode only.
No. Go to the right hand side, down below.
Okay.
Or press F5. Press F5. Shift F5.
Press F5. Okay, 1 minute. F5.
F5.
Okay. Did not come.
Okay. No, go to the right side. Go to the bottom. Yeah. Next one. Yeah, the next one. Okay. Yes, exactly. Yeah.
Okay. Is it clear now?
Yes, it is. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. This is what I said, learning experience. Thank you. Okay. So here actually, ahara is actually understood as something which is to be consumed, to eat, and akriyate iti ahara. I can hear some sounds. Can you please mute? Yeah. Akriyate iti ahara. That means something which gives a nourishment to the body when it is intaken. Only when it is intaken, that is to be underlined, because some people have a kind of dieting wherein they see the fruits and they understand that they'll get the benefits of the fruits. No way. It is only when it is intaken that the nourishment will happen. So what are these for? Like, why do we intake food?
Oh, please, please, please. Do it nicely. Not neatly.
Hello.
Okay. Somebody has to mute Ramesh Vinayak ji.
Okay. So the purpose of ahara is actually first to nourish. And so what are the benefits of it? We'll first see health, healing and harmony. So we are actually going towards a healing process of the whole body itself by means of intake of food. Because yesterday I was telling you about the ojas, that is very important in case of our immune power. Now, there is a saying in Ashtang Hridaya which goes like, if you take very less quantity of food, naturally the ojas will also come down, because the nutrition that actually has to go to the body, because when you are a small kid, you can take a little quantity of food. But as the age goes by, the quantity of food also has to increase to a certain level. It is not that you should eat a plate full, but to a certain level you have to intake, and then only you will be able to provide the nutrition to all the tissues that is very, very much essential to keep your health in a proper manner. And harmony. Harmony actually means that it is not only of the physical body, it is also of the mental body, and there is a connection between the physical and mental body, and that is possible with the help of food. Just for example, if you take biryani, which is actually having all the flavors and all, I think most of the people love biryani. That's why I took an example of biryani. The way our body responds after you take a biryani is generally like, if you are taking to the proper quantity, it is actually harmony. But if you intake more, then it will be sloggy. So that is the difference of taking correct food. So what happens is you are giving nutrition to both your senses, to your mind and to your body. That is actually the harmony. When the food is taken in such a manner, it will be the best, because the ojas that is provided, that is produced after all these, will be the at its best, creating balance of the doshas and dhatus. Now, the doshas are actually vata, pitta and kapha, and the dhatus, yesterday I told you, it's 7. And these doshas and dhatus are like, the doshas are always considered as a physiological pattern of the body, and dhatus are actually the structural components. So the physiology of a body will actually be determined by the base of food only. For example, once you do fasting, can one of you unmute and say, how do you feel after fasting?
Light.
Light, very good. Then?
Energetic.
Energetic, okay, great. Yes.
Shall I tell you my experience?
Yes, you can tell all experience. Then only I'll be able to connect.
Once I was fasting. Yeah. It was decided that I will fast for 1 week. So
I actually wanted to ask a person who will be taking more
days. 10% of the food that I take. So very small quantity, just a little bit of juice. This cabbage juice and something like this, very small quantities. And after 3 days, when I got up in the morning, I wanted to dance, I wanted to jump. There was so much energy.
Okay, after that, yes, let's come to the next part.
Yeah.
What happened on the fifth day?
It was really a very good experience. Experience in the body. For I did fasting for 2 weeks.
Okay. After this 1 week, when you had food, what was the first thing that you experienced?
Actually, I am a patient of hyperacidity, so there was less acidity. No acidity at all.
Oh, great. Not
that kind of decision. Okay. Whatever food suits me, that I will take. Not everything is meant for everybody. So yes. One of my German friends, she gave me this lesson that don't take these all these pills, they are poison. Eat what okay. your body demands. Don't eat what your body doesn't accept. So
okay. So we've heard an experience, an experience of fasting. Generally, actually, as she was telling, fasting is a process in which our cells take some time to re-energize itself, and there has been studies which shows that the cells are able to regenerate when we are putting to fasting. But I am not to tell that to go to her extent. Let's stop it for a day, because after that what happens is sometimes the body can become tired also, deprived of food. So one day per week was actually very good. After that, it is up to the body condition. See, she was able to take it up. But if you're able to take it up, it's fine. Otherwise, you will end up creating problems. The first thing what happens is that your vata and pitta will be a little bit agitated. So every person who does just for one day, the first thing they'll experience is some grumbling sensation will be there for some time. And then they take this juice or something else. After some period, they'll be having mild distension. After that, it will be removed if they are taking properly some liquid diet. But if they are used to having this fasting, they will not have this problem. So this is actually the balance of doshas, because we have this gastric juice that is secreted, and there is also a vata. Because there is no food, there will be some pervading air which is actually creating problems to the body. But at the same time, if you're taking enough quantity of something, some juice, that is why always juice fasting and all will actually help you benefit better. Because staying empty, it's not easy, as we are all very weak people. If we're very strong, we could have actually stood without food also, because that is the best way of having a fasting. But if at all you're not able to do so, you can also do this one day fasting. That's actually very good. So this will help enable a balance between the doshas and dhatus. Because once when you're fasting, you're creating that pattern wherein your vata and pitta will properly digest whatever was there. Whatever remnants was there, it will all get digested. As she was telling, on the third day, she was really bubbly. That is because she had so much of that unwanted material in her body that is completely being digested off. So the willpower can also be developed. At the same time, the digestion can be wonderfully kept once you undergo fasting. And your age, everything is a criteria. Or even if you're not able to do it for one whole day, you can even take it for one single meal. That it's also creating a difference. And then to enable easy digestion of food, thus enabling easy absorption, you're actually cooking the material with shadrasa. Generally, any food that we say is actually comprised, it's generally comprised of the six tastes that we use. You know, in Ayurveda, what we say is that you should have this sweet, sour, salty, and then spicy, bitter, and astringent taste in your food. Say, for example, if you are taking one, I don't know if you have taken a South Indian thali. If you have taken a South Indian thali, I would say all of these rasas come into play. The first thing that we intake is the ghee with a little bit of the pulses or the dal, and that is actually more sweet in taste, and that gives you the proteins which the body requires for energy building and also the muscle building part. And then you are intaking it with the carbohydrate, which is easily digested when you're intaking with these components. And then you have the sambar. Actually, the sambar is a combination of all of these rasas. You have madhura rasa with the pulses, and then you have amla, because amla or the sour taste and the salty taste because of the salt you add, and also the tamarind that you add into it. Tamarind and also tomatoes are also giving its flavor. And then most of the vegetables that we add in will have a little bit of bitter taste. If you have a some kind of, sometimes it will be astringent taste. Hingu that we add, turmeric that we had, all these have this bitter spiciness, for we add chili, and the bitter and astringent taste is being provided by the hingu that we add. Hing, I think it's the same, no, in Hindi also. Aparna ji, hello.
Yeah. Hello. Hello. Yeah. You wanted an English term for
that was what we add. So all these, it's a combination of all these shadrasas, and the shadrasas are developed in a way that it is not contradictory to each other also. So as I told you, we should not be mixing material which are contradictory. Like for example, the strawberry shake is actually contradictory, because this is a little bit, you have a sweet taste and a sour taste to it, and milk is completely against the sour taste. So adding this strawberry and milk is not a bad idea. It's not a very good idea at all. But at the same time, if you see sambar, we are not contradicting with any of the materials, and at the same time, it is only adding up to the benefit. So that's why sambar, such kind of traditional food, even if you check back into your traditional, some kind of recipe will be there, which actually have all these combinations of all the rasas. I think all of you will have some kind of recipes also, right? Which are very traditional, which your grandmother would have been making, which will have all these. Because these were based on the culture that we have and the traditional setup of means, which includes the pattern of our environmental changes to balance up with it, and then also our kind of gut inheritance. So both of these were taken into consideration always. Then cooking based on seasons. I would say in North, actually, you will have a difference, right, in cooking based on the seasons. Because in hot climate, you take food which are actually very cold in nature to the body. And at the colder seasons, you take material which are actually hot in nature and easily digestible. Which is actually not very easily digestible in cold season. And in hot season, actually, we use materials which are easily digestible. One of the best examples will be like in summers, generally, we use material like kanji, and especially when the rain starts, we use this kanji, which is actually a more of rice and water content. You can add pulses if at all you want to, and it is added along with this ajwain, a little bit of dry ginger, because it helps give you a mashup of all the materials getting easily digestible and absorbed. And at the same time, it gives you the enough hydration also, which you require during the season. So based on Ayurveda, actually, we advocate after some specific treatments, like there is a condition called like Panchakarma. We create a purification therapy of the whole body by means of 5 very difficult procedures called Panchakarma, which is actually preparing the body and then eliminating whatever is not necessary by the body through various procedures. So it's like 5 procedures we have. And post that, generally, the body will be very tired and it will require enough quantity to satiate the nutrition that has actually been drained out. So manda means it was only the fluid that has been drained after boiling the water. Now, this manda itself, that is the first thing that we give after the person undergoes this purification therapy. And the same can be used for any people who are dehydrated, in case of thirst, in case of actually diarrhea problems. All these conditions, you can use this because it has the content of carbohydrate, but in a very less ratio. So it will be easily digestible. It gives you the amount of carbohydrate and in a very satiable form, so it is not heavy to the body. And paya, second is paya, which is actually like paya and vilepi, you see, is like it will be having a quantity of water almost similar to the first picture that you see. You will have water and solid material almost equal. This will be taken by generally post-delivery. We actually advocate this along with some spices like Fenugreek is one of the main ingredients that we add, jaggery, and then dry ginger, because this will actually help them to get enough nutrition. At the same time, it will be properly digested. And this jaggery has got one more property. It helps in eliminating whatever is whatever has to be eliminated from the uterus, and helps it to come into position. And also that it is one of the material that has the property of improving the hemoglobin, which is very important during the lactation period, as it can actually affect the amount of calcium in the patient body. Next comes Odana. Odana is actually the rice, which is actually very, the material actually has a great play. Now, what you see in this material is actually just white rice, but generally the red variety of rice is actually advocated as per Ayurveda, because the red variety of rice has some properties which will give you enough quantity of selenium. The selenium is one thing which will be removed when it is fully polished. But when you are partially polishing it, it is like when you remove the husk and then just partially polishing it, you will retain that selenium. And this selenium is very important for the brain function. So that is why this red variety of rice was considered the best. But now, as of late, the red variety of rice you get only in Kerala. The problem is that the red variety of rice is very hard to boil and all that. Now people in Kerala also shifting to white rice. So the change in the nature. Now, yesterday I have already showed you, see the carrot actually going into the stomach, and this picture I wanted to show you yesterday, so I thought I'll put it today.
Ma'am, can you increase the size of the presentation? Presentation is very small in one tile, not able to see anything.
It is very small?
Absolutely small, just in one tile.
I think he has to change his screen.
Pin turnover.
He has to pin. That he has to do.
Okay.
There are
final
options.
Thank you.
Individual screens, there are options. We have to choose that.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Fine. Now you can see that in the first picture, you can see that the carrot is dropped down and the Agni is really very fiery. And then there is an Ama. It is actually that it is an improper Agni. The second picture shows proper Agni. It is not very sharp and it is not very mild. That is the way it should be. The moderation is very important, and the after digestion it gets flowered, so that it is actually that the Ama will not be developed at all, and the tissue will be properly formed. Okay, in the first picture what happens is there is Ama formation and the tissues are getting accumulated with that Ama. You can see that red dots in the tissue level, and here the tissue level you can see only one or two. That one or two will be removed once the Dhatu Pagagni, for after immediately after this formation of this flower, this will undergo a kind of paga when it is coming into contact with Rasa Dhatu Agni. As I told you, each Dhatu has got also this Agni. And so once it attacks the Rasa Dhatu Agni, whatever is not necessary will be thrown out. So in that place itself, it will be thrown out. And so the tissue that develops afterwards, it will be perfect. So these are the tissues. I just wanted to show you a pictorial representation of Rasa, which is the intercellular fluid and the extracellular fluid. You would have seen in the cell structures and all, you have so many organs and so many mitochondria and all that. So when we comprise every liquid material to Rasa, and then recta is actually the hemoglobin part, or the that which actually gives coloring to the Rasa. And then mamsa is actually the muscular layer that we have actually like a covering to our body. And next you see is actually the medhus. Medhus is the adipose tissue. Now, do you think adipose tissue is not required, or the fat content is not required in our body? One of you, please.
Of course it is required, you know. Otherwise,
of course
I think
it is required.
Because without that, you know, we cannot function. The bodily movement and mobility is difficult.
I actually, one of you told, no, for 7 days she was fasting.
Yes, yes, yes.
It would have been this adipose tissue only that is actually helping her during this fasting period. Okay. Okay.
I think Shashi Balaji said that.
Yes. And then comes Asthi. Asthi is actually the bony part. So you know that it is very rough. It should be really tough. So do you think that every material will help in improving Asthi? Asthi is actually the bony tendency, you know. Anything that is very bony in part is actually Asthi. You can see the structural components of our body. If you have to have a shape, you need a structural component to the body, and that is actually provided by the bony structure that we have got. And it is actually encompassing, or it is giving a covering to the internal visceral organs, which are very, very soft in nature. And so this bony part has a great role to play in our body, especially only when we have a small fracture in our body, we understand that part was how so useful to us. So this bone, you cannot actually, you know, we understand it by the tendency of the calcium importance or the bone density that we've got and all that. But let me tell you, like, any material which is actually very hard in nature can actually provide the asthitva in our body. Like, for example, just by having this pain in the knee joint, you know, if you apply a kind of paste with egg shell, which has got that porous nature, if you apply, it actually works. So this is called the property of Samanya Guna. Samanya Guna means anything that has the property of the same dhatu will help in improving the dhatu. That is why Shukra is actually the reproductive tissue and Majja is actually the marrow. So in case of Shukra, the Shukra has got the properties of milk. So when you have to improve the quantity of semen or the quantity of altogether the seminal fluid, because these are the infertility issues are on the high nowadays. So in such a condition, milk is one of the best combination, because milk has got the same properties of that of the Shukra. But in case of the female reproductive system, it's a little bit different. There you have to actually use the tila. Tila is actually the sesame seed, which can be used either in the form of seed itself or in the case of oil, because the consideration of the quality of the ovum is actually a little bit fiery. Only then you have a real combination, because one, if both goes to become cold in nature, the formation will actually become a little bit, the correct formation will not happen. So it one that is actually the sperm is actually cold in nature and the ovum is actually fiery in nature, so that when it comes to contact, only a proper zygote formation happens. So that is why in case of menstrual fluid problems and all that, the sesame or sesame seed and sesame oil has a great role to play. Okay. Then comes mala. This is also very important. As I told you yesterday, most of the Ayurvedic physicians would ask you, do you really have your bowel habit daily? And then how do you have it? There are so many questions. And then comes urine output. So these are all very important, because the three mode of excretion has been understood in Ayurveda as sveda, that is a sweat, urine or the mutra, and the feces, that is a purisha. So any food that you intake in the body has to be properly digested. Only when it is properly digested, it will undergo a proper elimination also from the body. Otherwise, it will stay stagnant in the body. So once it undergoes that proper transformation, it will be eliminated completely also. So that time period to get it eliminated is very important. So how are you going to take the food when you are going to make the food and eat the food? There are some things that has to be very carefully noted. One thing that you understand is that when you make food itself, actually my mentor, the Krishna Kumarji, used to say, by the quantity of food or the way of food, the food is prepared itself, you can analyze the cook mentality. The taste of the food itself will denote the mentality of the cook. That is why our the food that is actually prepared by our mom or grandmother, it's very tasty. because they put their heart into it rather than giving that only that kind of just a cooking material. It is actually that they want to give something which is very healthy to the baby, or something that is actually freshly prepared. You are not taking something for children. If you are consider a mother, they'll not be giving the children a very stale food and all that. It will be mostly fresh food. So that is how it has to be given. And that attitude of giving is also very important. Giving, caring, all that is very important. And generally, as per the tradition also, you see that most of the mothers will actually have their bath and then only cook, because it is understood that it is not only becoming clean, it is also that becoming holy in a way, so that whatever goodness that the mother has will be surpassed through the meal that she prepares. And the second line you can see, you should not prepare meal or eat meal because when you are upset or stressed, because so much of that emotion creates that negative vibes and your acid levels will be in such variable condition, and it can surely affect your digestive system in a great deal. One of the best examples is irritable bowel syndrome. It is such a disease wherein you get a little bit upset, immediately the stomach shows up the character. You have to rush to the bathroom. So that is actually one of the simplest diseases. And next, practice mindful eating. This is very, very, very important, because you would see nowadays that all of this gadgets, technical gadgets, have actually taken place in our dining table also. So it is my humble request that that has to be removed, because all the focus has to come mentally and physically to the food, so that what happens is the material that we are using in that goes to the body as in a relished manner. The problem is that when you're using the spices and all that, we just understand it's only spices, because research has proved that some of the spices have got wonderful reaction on our mood levels, on our psychological levels also. So the psychological balance itself can be created. Now, especially when it comes to this COVID condition and all of us were in lockdown and taking so much of food. So intake of food has to be regulated, timely, and taken as per the need of the body. When you are taking so much of meal, what happens is the body has to work out so much to expel it out from the body. So what happens is ultimately you get tired of it. So try to reduce the quantity of food if you feel that your body is getting tired. And you understand the difference. If your body is getting tired because lack of nutrition, then you have to add the quantity whichever is intended to. You have to add materials such as milk, ghee, nuts, vegetables, fruits, everything regularly. I always say that you go to the supermarket, you see every vegetables, right? You should have all the vegetables every week. That is how you should plan. Do not cut off any vegetable that is not healthy, telling any other reasons except for allergy conditions. Because many vegetables are like yam. For some people, it can create an itchy sensation. Then you are not supposed to take that. Otherwise, brinjal. These some vegetables only has that property. Apart from that, all of these vegetables are very good and it can be relished in a bright way also. So make sure that you take that. Next comes Ashtavidhi Ahara Vishesha Ayatanas. These are actually 8 components that comprise of a food. So prakriti is the constitution of the food itself. As I told you, the milk, you know, the milk is a property of being cold in nature. It is very cold to the body and at the same time very nourishing. Anything that is cold to the body is mostly nourishing. Okay, so this milk, what happens is it is sweet in taste, and after the end of digestion also it is sweet in taste. So it is very nourishing in nature, and but it is heavy. So what happens is you should not be taking 3-4 glasses of milk. You should be taking maximum 1-2 glasses of milk. And you should take it at a time, not very late at night, not in a way that it is getting sloggy. That is, though it is in a liquid form also, it should get completely digested. Karana. Karana is the how you're taking it. in a material or in a glass, there are variances of utensils actually. It's called the instrument. Any vessel which actually has, like nowadays we use copper, but when you're using milk along with copper and all, you should be very careful. Samyoga is having a great role to play, as I told. Using of the sore material along with milk can create problems. So that such kind of combinations to be avoided. It is best to take fruits as such. It is best to take milk as such. Pulses can be mixed, not a big problem. But apart from that, in the pulses itself, this rajma and all has got a light sour taste. No, such pulses should not be mixed together easily. Then rashi. Rashi is actually like in what period of time you're taking. That is actually like very important. Desha is in which place you're taking the food. Actually, when you go to Rome, behave like a Roman, they say. It's like a proverb. But the proverb literally means that you should be taking the food of that place. Then only your body will be conducive to it. But that doesn't mean that you should take in large quantities. You can take in minimal quantities so that you do not create harm to your digestive. Kala is that some grains, like the grains are actually considered, grains, pulses, are all considered to be taken after at least after a year. This rice, pulses and all that. Because once it gets, after harvesting, if it is stored for 1 year, it becomes light to digest. Otherwise, what happens is it's very heavy. And it will, once you cook also, you will feel it very slimy in nature. So what happens is that sliminess will ultimately create problems in your body. Upayoga samstha means how you are taking it. So either you cook it or you fry it or you or different procedures or the processes you are going to do it is upayoga samstha. And upayokta is the person. So finally it is I who decide what I should be taking and which is good for me. So that upayokta has a great role to play. He is the person, he or she is the person who will decide the whole of the other 7 people. So thank you. My presentation is over.
Are there any questions?
Yeah, we'll go on to the questions now.
Yeah. And I would also like to talk to Dr. Aramya about the yes. 5 kinds of Agni that I raised a question yesterday.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
please. I want to make it clear that what was in my mind going on at that time. Mm-hmm. In the 8th century text from mm-hmm. Indonesia, it is written on Shaiva philosophy.
Okay.
And there it is mentioned that there are 5 kinds of 5 elements in our body. Prana, Pana, Samana, Udana and Vyan, most of the people know. But yesterday we talked about Agni. So according to that text I am quoting that it is Mahagni in Mukha, Garhaspatyagni in Udara, Dakshinagni in Hridaya, Samvartakagni in Pitta, Ashuchyagni in Payupastha and Chakshushagni in eyes. Then there are 5 kinds of Prithvi Tattva, that is Mans and Asthi, Snayu, Kesh, Rom and Nails. Then up, it describes Rudhir, Mutra, Reth, Sruvet, Shleshma, Majja, Medha, etc. So Akash, about Akash, it writes that 5 kinds of Akash in our body is in Shrotra, Chakshu, Mukh, Hriday and Payupastha.
Okay, thank you, Shashmi. It's a new learning for me.
Yeah, it's from a
Shaiva text. It can be comprehended with Ayurveda. You said, It can be comprehended because there is, as I told you, this malas, this dhatu and all this has got some other connections with the other tissues also. Yeah. I did not explain much because it's too technical. So I didn't want to explain here. So that is actually what you are connecting with.
Yeah.
So thank you. I'll contact you.
I studied it 40 years ago, but that was in my mind somewhere.
Great. It's always helpful, you know, like some points will be very helpful when we come into contact, especially in clinic. So mm-hmm. each little thing is important. Yes. So I think we have some questions already.
Aramya, If anybody could ask questions, I want to, you know, throw certain questions onto you as a common man.
Okay.
We were talking of Bhara, which is like, you know, quite important part of our life. And as you were talking, at one point of time, you were talking about that when you're angry, upset, you're stressed out, you're not supposed to eat. Supposed to eat as in, I mean to say that, okay, you know, you just relax, you let your body relax, yes, and then start eating.
Exactly.
I want, you know, there is, I feel there is 90% of people are stressed out all the time. They are angry all the time. You know, there are so many things going on all the time. And there is so much of, you know, what do you call it, as a hurry up, you know, because you have to catch something, you have to attend something. There are, and after this online platform, I think people are left with no time. Let me just tell you, because a lot of people are really, really, you know, they have gone overboard with everything. There is no time left. There is no personal space left for them. And the, you know, they're running around in the home and eating. Thank you. Yes, you know, it's really sad to see, you know, the young boys and girls attending their school. Like yesterday, there was this lady who says that they are always online. I don't know when to give them food. At 11, they are having food at one stretch. So these are all very sad statements that we are hearing, that we are not giving any importance to food. It takes 20 minutes to eat a food at one time, one point of time. Say, for example, lunch or dinner. That 20 minutes, you know, we are finding it difficult and challenging to take, which is the primary reason for all other things, actually. Exactly. You know, the next, all that, you know, importance of ahara comes later. You know, if you're not able to take the 20 minutes of your peaceful time and very happy time to eat food, and that mindfulness, which I am, you know, keep on doing a lot of sessions here, mindful eating, mindful doing, it's very difficult to bring that attention mindfully to people. You know, the mindfully, what you got to do? It's just out of context. Can you just explain this to a commoner? You know, how, you know, even if you are in a stress, I know there is, you can't put aside all your work. But besides that, also, there must be something that we can do to at least gain certain, you know, nourishment from the food that we eat.
Actually, since I see many people who are a little above an age, I really feel that these are the people who can guide on. Because I really feel that only from our generation, like, we have running for no reason, literally speaking, for no reason, we're literally running, and that is something which we have to take up from our elder generation. We need to understand that some point of time we have to sit and think. That has to be taught to the younger generation also, and the family time has to be spent with food, I would say, because generally, at least dinner was part of, you know, if you see a middle class family, until 10 years back, all of them at least had the dinner together. Because that was the period wherein caring, sharing, everything happened. The whole day event, everything came into place. And that actually helped them to understand things, what is happening in each other's life. But now if you ask me about my husband, I'll have to think. That is the condition of each person in everyone's life. So as Aparna ji was telling, that some period of time when you're concentrating on food, it's very important, because that mindful eating was very important, because, you know, and generally school, the cutlery was never mentioned for us to eat. It was actually the hand that was mentioned in Ayurveda. It is explained also, you should cut off your nails, you should keep your hands, you should wash. Yes. All that has been mentioned. So that actually means that you should be eating with your hand also. That was to connect the body and the food. It was actually to connect the body and the food. So that connection, it was more spiritual understanding rather than eating something which is just carbohydrate and protein. It was actually in a form that you are giving some very sattvic material to the body rather than just eating carbohydrate food and then minerals and all that. So what happens is, every time we eat, we are giving a kind of transformation of these material to hormones. And these hormones have a large role to play in every minute, every second, because these hormonal changes can be psychological, can be physiological. It can be in either way. So psychological thing can be easily changed when you are taking the food in a proper manner. But at the same time, physiological things can be done only by the material of food that we intake. So the material of food has to be intaken for creating that physical change, and the attitude of how you take food is very important to create that psychological change.
Dr. Ramya, since we are talking about Americans, earlier days we used to sit on the ground and take food. Now we are, everybody has a dining table and chair and our
sir, if you ask me, I have seen patients with knee osteoarthritis of even 30 years. Can you imagine? And I have seen a person of 79. He came walking straight to my clinic and he did not have even a slight sound of crepitus. I was like, how can I compare? Right. That was the amount of, that was the feel, you know, like as a clinician, we understand that so much of thing has to do with generation gap. I think many of the things we have left out, and those are the gaps that has to be filled in for the next generation so that we impart health to them.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Aramya, my question again from the commoners only. Since we were talking about food, after this COVID, you know, there is a lot of people have changed their lifestyle, I would say.
Right.
And a lot of people have opted for Ayurvedic way of life. It's one way it is great, and in the other way it is taking, you know, too much actually on their health. Why? Because I have a lot of people complaining about when they started taking adrak, you know, that's a ginger, or anything very similar to a concoctions, or you know, something related to Ayurvedic way of eating. They just overdo it because they wanted to stay good, stay healthy, and consuming adrak in a day is round about 100 grams to 150 grams for somebody who's never eaten ginger. And that's just because, you know, overeating and overdoing everything, there is no moderation. Similarly, there is also the cinnamon also taken in large quantities, large as in, if you say, if you are supposed to take only 2 grams a day, just quoting it. And if the person is taking 10 grams in a day, it's obviously
below 2 grams.
Yes. So, you know, these are certain things. And I also wanted you to explain about why we should not take honey in hot water. If you can, because generally this is a perception, and you can see the ads, Amitabh Bachchan telling that garam pani mein, you know, you put honey and you will become slim.
Completely.
Girls are all mad about, you know... So, you know, I just wanted to say, you to tell, if I am sure there must be more young people,
you know, actually,
also in this, if they are listening to this.
Yeah, as you were telling, no, these are some points which are actually basics of Ayurveda also. I did not tell this actually when you combine material. It is actually mentioned that you should not be taking equal dosage of honey along with ghee. It is actually mentioned that you should not be heating honey. So these are some of the processes that you should not do. Because just as a counter, I was also pondering on what it is. And I found a research which showed that the honey which is heated actually produces an aldehyde. And that aldehyde is actually poisonous in nature. And I was surprised, by the way, because the book has been written 5,000 years back when they did not have any chemical testing. And there it has been mentioned that once you heat the honey, it becomes poison. That is the surprises that we have in day-to-day life when we read the actual text. So it is that these materials are advised to be taken, you know, even this honey itself, we are using in many of the medicine forms also. But all these medicine forms will be in a cold nature only when we add this honey, so that we are not heating it. Okay? Just like that, as you were telling, you are not supposed to... Yeah, one more question you questioned, right? What was that? I missed it out.
Yeah, that is that consuming, you know, all this adrak and cinnamon, yes, all these things.
You know, everything
in moderation.
Even this honey itself, you can see people, taking so much of honey, a morning honey, evening honey, they understand that it is actually very good for the body. But let me tell you, it has got the property of Sharanam. Sharanam means it actually creates an eroding tendency. That is why it is one of the best medicine to be taken in the morning, but not in hot water. Because when it is taken in the morning, what happens is every one of us, we have that kapha nature in the morning when we get up. So that can be removed to a certain extent. That is why it is advised in the morning. But that is actually, you require only 1 teaspoon of it. What happens when you take more of honey? It means that you are trying to create problems to your agni again. Because it is one of the material which is very hard to digest. Okay. And the same way, all of these spices, it has got the spicy tinge. Whatever has got that spicy tinge are advised to be taken only in very, very, very small quantity. Very small quantity. Otherwise, what happens is you will end up getting problems of acidity, erosions. You know, there'll be erosions in the stomach. It can even lead to ulcers, gastric ulcers, duodenal ulcers when you're continuously using this. Actually, what happened during this corona period was that they had this the Ayush norms were mentioned, and that it was mentioned that water along boiled along with ginger, and I should say that it was a very absurd thing. People started using ginger like anything. You know, everything in moderation.
Yes.
One question I can say is, some say ghee is good, vegan people say ghee, oil, dairy is not needed. I would say, like, if you are confused about the kind of food, I would just simply ask you to follow what your grandmother would be using. That was the best food that your body you can provide, because they did not have any fancy foods. They did not have any of the combination which is not necessary. If you look into their kind of food intake or the way the food combinations were done, everything is mentioned as per Ayurveda. I can 100% surely say. So that is the best way. And you take food, whatever is necessary to your body, intake in very small quantities. If your body is conducive to it, you can take in enough quantity. That is the best way.
Thoda chai ke baare mein bataiye, madam. How many tea in the
One to two. That is it. And in limited quantities. The problem is that the chai is actually understood that you have this theobromine, which actually helps in improving that freshness. But let me tell you, it is very short-lived. That freshness will be there only for a small period of time. But all of us are addicts to tea. So 1 to 2 cups would not create much of a problem. But if you're taking above that, what happens is your hunger would have that hunger pangs, or the proper digestion will be a kind of disturbed. So one day you will not feel much of a problem. But if you continue to do so, it will eventually get to become a problem, especially like acidity problems, and that will be on the rise. And don't take acidity very simply, because people have this GERD problems, cannot even sleep properly. So it is best to control all these kind of foods. Shift on to lime juice. That is okay, but not lime juice in a very high quantity is like, again, it is going to create that acidity, because it's got acid automatically in there. But at the same time, if you are shifting to normal water, it is fine, because that is neither acidic nor alkaline. So that is the best one, because you provide enough nutrition. At the same time, that hydration will be proper, and you have to take it sip by sip.
Aramya, there is, I think from my side, there will be a last question. As again a commoner, I'm asking you, since people are working from home and there is not much of a mobility for a lot of people, unless if they are willing to take a walk around, you know, and there are a lot of people I have come across, they have a hunger pangs. Like, I won't say it is a hunger, it's just, you know, wanted to have something on the other while working, you know, on their table, there should be something. What is the best way to stay away? One, if so, what is the best thing that they can consume?
I would say it is always best to stay away from consuming things, because once you start consuming, that becomes a habit. Rather than moving out of it, it is best to move out of it. Once you decide, you can move out of it. Especially like try to create a pattern that you will take food only at some specific place, like a dinner table. Then what happens is that kind of tendency itself will come. That is a mentality, you know. We don't want to spoil the other places. Absolutely. So that is one kind of mentality. There, so what happens is whenever you want to eat something, it is only available at that place. So what happens is anyway, you will get up, and maximum time of getting up also will be reduced automatically. That's that's because we have that lazy person also in us.
Yes,
so that will also be cut off.
The amount of water in a day during the summer, during the winter, during the different seasons, how much water should be taken during the day?
The quantity your body asks for. I will not say 3 liters, 2 liters. It is only the quantity of water your body asks.
Absolutely.
Because, you know, unless otherwise you are sitting in an environment opposite to that of the environment outside, you will have to adjust. Yes. If you are sitting in a normal atmosphere, when you are talking more, or when you are actually singing or something, using your throat more, you will demand more water. But that should also be in sipfuls. If you're drinking, gulping water, what happens is ultimately you're creating problems to your stomach. So you should always be sipping. And if you are sitting in a very, like in an AC room or so, try to use hot water, and that also sips. That you should actually make sure that you're drinking, because any person who's sitting in an AC will actually undergo what happens is the body will get dried, because the AC, the cold air conditioning is that the air will be very cold in nature. It will be like dry heat. There is a dry, because of the cold nature, you're actually creating dryness to the body. So that should not happen. So that those people should eventually be taking ghee and water in equal quantities.
No question.
We have a question from Mr. Abhiram. And Abhiram ji, I will share Dr. Aramya's number with you. You can,
I don't think
you can speak to her directly.
No, actually, I cannot for height, I cannot help you. I'm sorry.
Yes.
It is only that because I would genetically, my only advice is put them to some kind of sports. That's enough.
Hello, ma'am. I had a question. Hi. Can I ask?
Right. Yeah. Please go ahead.
Yeah, ma'am. So nowadays, like on various sites, we read that 60 grams of protein is needed, or like in micro and macronutrients too, there is some limit that you should have these amount of magnesium and all. So what does Ayurveda has to say? Like if we eat milk and egg, there is some problem, or like if we combine two types of food to increase the protein content, so there is some type of problem. So what is your opinion in that topic?
I am strictly against this dieting pattern here. I would say like our body is not conducive to it, especially when you talk about this protein, because the material that we are taking is actually very hard to digest, and our body and at the same time our climate should be really, it will end up giving a very high load on the kidneys. Actually, that is why when you're intaking these proteins and all, you should be very, very careful. Only when your body is able to digest that material, you can take. I'm not strictly against it, but I don't think so you need a protein. Instead, you can shift to daily intake of any of our pulses. You will get that equal amount of protein, whatever you were saying. Actually, in Tamil Nadu, I have seen as chat itself, like an evening snack, the pulses would be just salted with a little bit of ginger or green chilies or red chilies. And then it was taken with a little bit of grated coconut. It will taste very, it is called sundal. It is a commonest practice, you know, like even when you go to a hut also, you will get that. Even if you go to the richest person here also, you can get that, because it was considered a very
healthy. That's the pala chenna. Yeah, it's a kala channa in Hindi.
It can be kala channa, it can be green gram, it can be red gram, anything of that sort. Because I always feel that when you're taking material as whole, don't take any of the tinned material, because it's not in it. We don't have to go for tinned material. We have everything fresh and raw. You can actually use it fresh. So anything that is processed will not give you the enough quantity of material that your body requires. So go for the whole quantity, it's whole material itself. If you use any of the pulses in such a manner, it will be very good for you. And this pulses itself, you can ground it and make it into powders. They make this laddu and all that, you know, with the powders, besan laddu, like that. You can have this nutritional material so that it is tasty also in a way. And at the same time, you add ghee and all that to it. You will not have any problems, because these pulses actually have a tendency of creating this gastritis condition if you're taking regularly. So that is why I told you to add a little bit of ginger, or otherwise you add a little bit of garlic. All these will actually create a nice balance. So this was better option than taking protein powders.
Is can nuts be taken as raw is better, or nuts could be cooked? Like, you know, we make nuts into the mix with something else.
It is not necessary that you cook the nuts. Actually, it is fine that you can take it just like that also.
So, is it recommended to soak them over the night and then take it?
Generally, for this almonds alone, I have seen them soak, but it's actually to remove that peel. Actually, rather than that, it has got nothing to do. Except for this dry grapes, you know, the dry black grapes, once it is soaked, it actually becomes much more colder. Actually, it is cold in nature. By nature itself, it is cold. If you want to make it a little bit colder, you can do that. And it, once it gets soaked in water and if you consume, it is one of the best things for constipation.
And how do we know what kind of body you have? You have a vata body, kapha body, or pitta body?
What are you going to do after you understand that?
To eat or adjust my diet accordingly.
Just forget that and eat. That is the best way. Because once you know, let me tell you, it is more like a fad that you are trying to understand. It is your vata, pitta, and kapha. Our grandparents did not know, our parents did not know, but they are living healthier than we. So it is best actually to forget all that. Eat food which is actually very much conducive to you. Yeah.
Ramya, I wanted to ask, adding to what he said, because since that lot of people now understand doshas and everybody wants to know what kind of a dosha they have and accordingly they eat, which is, I think, quite okay if they wanted to know.
But the problem is,
tell me one thing.
Aparna, what happens is, they will be very choosy then. That choosiness should not come. Actually, it can be very simple.
When you tell that go with the flow and eat whatever that you pattern, you mean to say the body can recognize its own food and then reject a certain food if you are paying attention and mindfully eating. You know, only because that, I have known my pattern. I have known my food items, which I can eat, when I cannot eat, during night and morning. All that pattern I know. And similarly, a lot of people who are eating mindfully, who are eating with that kind of an attention to the body, I think they all understand. It's only, I think, what your body rejects, you should stop that.
Yes. That is why when I told you about the vegetables and all, I mentioned about that yam, brinjal, because these are some things which actually create that problem. So just try to avoid like that. For example, mushrooms. Mushrooms cannot be helpful in many of the people. It is actually tridosha hara. It increases all the tridoshas. That is why we are advising that this, we call it chatrika. It should not be used, mushrooms. But what happens is nowadays people are fad of it. So it is not that you should not be taking it completely, but take it in moderate quantity so that your body is taking some time to digest it properly. You should not take it at night. Those are the things that you should be knowing. You know, when you are trying to understand that your body is vata, the best thing that you should add on is add a little bit of sesame oil to your diet. when you feel okay. your body is actually becoming more fiery in nature, just add a little bit of ghee to it. And then when it is more into the kapha, you have that phlegm consistency, some indications. Those are some indicators. In such condition, add a little bit of honey. Those three materials, if you have in your house itself, you will be able to balance all the three. So don't think too much of that. But make sure you're looking to what the body says, because the body is the best mirror. It is actually like you can actually watch out for every symptom. It will give that signals, but those signals are actually missed out by us. So just look into that signal and you will be able to live better. Okay, I think we'll stop for today. Patients are waiting.